Hey everybody, thanks for joining me for Habitat Now here at the Seattle Art Fair. We had an amazing opening last night, lots of attendance, lots of amazing artwork, so I'm going to give you a glimpse into the displays here in our booth, as well as some other booths that have caught my attention. So sit back, relax, enjoy, and I'm honored to have you join me today. Those who are watching on YouTube, please like, subscribe, hit that bell, and share this with people who love artwork that we have here at Habitat and beyond. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop this video and I'll start another one. We'll be in touch. First and foremost, center of our booth, our friend Martin Blank, local artist, two beautiful lotuses that he has created. Centerpiece to our display. Debbie usually hangs out in this chair and talks to everybody while I hang out and have a dialogue with others, so it's great to see. Vivian's Wang's two newest works. These are heavily inspired by the clothing they're wearing. There's write-ups in each one of these. This is her newest body of work in which she's incorporating these very fun animals. I'll take some time here to kind of give you an idea of her style and technique. And this piece has, I believe, little gems on the body of the work itself. If you can focus it. Beautiful face and hair, larger figure, look at that, sitting on a pillow, and this is her little monkey friend, a gorgeous sculpture by our friend Vivian. We'll just scale around it, had a lot of response, people loved the work. First day of the show was well received. Yeah. Big fan of Vivian's, she sends us her best. All the way from Palm Beach. Her other little friend, I believe this one is has to do with a rabbit. Let me see the title here. Yep, Flemish Bunny. She might have renamed it. I have to check my notes, but look at the texture. Look at the outfit on this incredible little guy. What a beauty. See our little bunny friend. Took me a minute to figure out how to strap the string around the hand, similar to the way Vivian did it. But I wanted to give you a glimpse of these works. The other one, this one's called Snub-Nosed Bunny, or Snub-Nosed Monkey. Next, we're going to a new artist we've just started showing named Carrie Side. She is here at the show. These are actually, I think they're aluminum, acrylic, mylar, and plexiglass. So there's something amazing about these works that just change in tone and color as you visually walk around the room. She's been creating for a long time and we're honored to have her in the show. Cool, we've had some success selling her work already. She's new for us. Something quite exciting. Something new. Got our wonderful About Habitat sign, and then we have two wonderful masterpieces by Peter Hora. Both are incredible. Pick your color, blue or purple. At the right angle, the sides glow. Like, look at that blue. And look at that purple. It's just so vivid. Both masterpieces, I'm a huge fan. I have a piece similar to this in my collection, but smaller to fit my home. Three wonderful of his maquette pieces, different colors and tones. These were created in homage of his larger works. We showed these for the first time in 2019, and Peter Hora keeps making more. Incredible work by Cassandra Blackmore, Orange. She is so in demand. Everybody here in Seattle knows her. I suspect this piece won't last very long. It is quite large at 40 by 40. It is immaculate. In our back area here, we got some sculptures by Deanna Clayton. This is two of her well-known and very successful female series. Blue and I guess it would be like an amber, made out of pate vert and copper. Beautiful and peaceful. We did well with this work in the Sarasota show. Down here, we have a little bit of her more well-known work, The Vessel Forms. Your choice, blue or blue, but different color shades of blue. Very popular. And down here at the bottom, more of the Hora mini pieces for people to choose from, different colors and tones, blue, purple, orange, and green. I love this green series. It's called Domas back here. It's one of my favorite. All right, and now we're coming to some of the larger pieces. We have the huge piece by Jenny Pullman and Sabrina Knowles, the tapestry. It looks incredible. We had it installed in the gallery on white, but wow, does it look much better on the dark wall. You can see the details. You come up close. And luckily, Jenny and Sabrina were here to help install this because, man, is it laborious. But it's a lot of fun to see them put this kind of thing together. This is their newest work, and these videos don't do this work justice. They are quite beautiful. I think they're gleasy prints is the terminology, with their metalwork and glass forms. Something exciting. So new, we didn't have tags made. They're bringing them with them today for us, so I'm grateful to that. And now we got our new Luna spear, big installation. Keep backing up. Wow, what a piece. What a masterpiece. 90 inches round. It is quite incredible and breathtaking, and everybody is drawn to see this particular masterpiece on the wall. Steel and copper. It's just a beauty, beautiful piece. And then one of the stoppers of the show too, the Untitled Guardians piece. I'm so excited about this work. Many of you have seen me sending out, you know, emails promoting the show. This has been the centerpiece for our booth. It is an immaculate work, and I'm honored to have it in our space. If you have a chance to talk to Jenny and Sabrina about the work, it started with one idea and has become others, but it is one of my favorite. They've been doing this type of work for over 30 years, but it's one of my favorite series of theirs. Something new this year is an artist named Jennifer and Thor Bueno. A very fun wall installation work, different scale and sizes. We had another piece that was silver and gold, which I can send anybody pictures of. We just ran out of room in our space. But look at the textures. It all mounts on a single screw per piece. And this particular one went up quite easily once we followed the instructions of where everything went. But it is a beautiful work. We're excited about them, and it's priced rather well. This piece is priced at $13,000 and change, but it's quite big. All right, we'll kick over to our friend Wilfred Grootens. We have three of his works here, only one on display at the moment. This is one of his masterpieces, the gold vessel form. It is large and it is immaculate as well. Look at the tone and color. Grateful to have Wilfred in our gallery. Such an optical experience. People ask how this work is made all the time, and I feel like I am a record repeating it over and over again, but that's the fun of it. Get to teach people about the world we love. And last is our friend Marta Klanowska. This is our showstopper as well, to get people to come stop by and see us. Many of you have seen this work in the gallery. It's rare to have her work available. And we have two. We have green and blue. They are sisters, and they are our friends. So they need to go out for a walk, so come by the gallery and take them out. Have a visit. See us here at booth A17 here at the Seattle Art Fair. I'm going to skedaddle back a little bit to give you a panoramic of our space. And I'm going to go and see if what else there is to show you guys. So I'll be back in 2 minutes. Thanks. So like many of the fairs we attend, something wild and fun. Backing up, this is larger than life size. I feel like it is quite an incredible work. When I zoom around, I'll tell you the artist's name. It is Mimi Sturman, right? Did I nail that? Mimi Sturman. It comes apart for installation. You know, you need this in your front room. It's beautiful bunny, and it has a whole story behind it. I'll tell you about it. He just handed me a piece of paper about it. Something wild to see here at the Seattle Art Fair. I could probably handle the little guy down here with the bug on his back. How fun is that? Give you a quick glance around the booth. Other wild stuff at the show. And we'll continue our time here at Seattle Art Fair. And we're not to touch this guy. This is something wild on display here at the show. Vibrating water as if it's a well. Kind of hangs out on the floor and gives you kind of an experience for the piece. The artist's name is Peter Gronquist, made in 2022. Very wild. Something different. And it is huge. Gives you an idea of the space they gave to this piece at the fair. I love seeing new technology invested into artwork. And this is something completely different. These are like LEDs that form a giant visual, they call it a campfire. I won't be surprised if it changes color. Right now it's on purple. Something wild that I've never quite seen before. Obviously, gonna have to plug it in. We're getting used to that in today's world. Very interesting. Remember, these also act as night lights, so you don't fall going to the bathroom at night. How crazy is that? Very cool. Robert Stone. No, the name is Mads Christensen. Very cool. One of the highlights of the show is right at the entrance, the first ever Preston Singletary totem on display for public view. It is an incredible piece. I think it costs about $600,000. It is took them 10 hours to install this piece. You can see there's different levels that form together to create the whole piece. There's pictures of it online. You saw pictures with Preston sitting next to it. It's worth every penny. What a marvelous creation that Preston created. I've seen these in private collections, but this is the first one I've seen in public, and it is massive. Great for him to include it in this exhibition. I'll give you a look from the side and behind. In the casting, this is obviously the part facing up, which you can see right through the piece. Glass is quite an amazing material. Give you the views of both sides immediately. But this is definitely one to put some time into if you come to the show to see, because it is quite incredible. Thank you, Preston, for sharing this with us. I wanted to stop by the Traver booth here, Seattle-based gallery. Hey, Sarah.
Hey, Aaron.
Good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
We're doing a little bit of a walkthrough. We just took a look at the big piece and had a chance to talk about that.
Cool.
So we're going to... This is a recording, so
it's not live,
yep, okay. So don't feel like you're on the spot, but I wanted to take a chance to walk through the booth before the show started. Beautiful works. I think we got some more unique sculptures running around. Very cool birds. Multiple artists, you check out Sarah's website. Contact her, these are very, very fun. And then more of Preston's work. If you had a chance to see his installation in Washington, D.C., definitely do that. It is incredibly moving about the story of the raven. Creates a whole experience. Look at this tentacle. Wow, look at that. I love the narrative about his work. So interesting, the walls we would fill up with artwork, and they put sculpture on display. So check it out. Another artist I'm not that familiar with, but I want you to learn. This is Marita Dingus. Another smaller totem, just an idea. Pricing, $1,000. So the big one. There's six of those, I guess. But look at that face. How great is that? That's amazing. We'll continue on the tour. Some wall installation work. And some more wall installation work. And probably a little family by Dingus, if I'm pronouncing that right. How fun. Well, come to the fair and check out the booth. Some interesting artwork at the show. Yep. Melissa Morgan Fine Art. One of these insane visual cubes, or tetrahedron, whatever it is. Very wild. We've seen these at art fairs before. I think the Imagine Museum owns one. We'll skedaddle into my favorites in here. This is kind of a preview before the show, because it opens up in about half an hour, maybe less. This is kind of fun. If I had a rocket launcher, it says, and sparkles. Another mirrored box. I love this work. This is fun stuff. Not quite life-size, but the detail's incredible. This one's life-size. I feel like she can open her eyes any second now. Ha! That is incredible. This looks like it's some maybe form of glass here. Got our gold guy in the corner. This looks like a 3D moving mirror. I've seen this kind of stuff. Very interesting. Never seen it move before. More of the work. Very cool. Okay, Spark Gallery has a collection of the fun and colorful work of Stephen Cox. And some other pieces on display. Hi guys, doing well. Just taking a quick video for the Zoom today. Hope everybody's doing great. Very fun. Look by some of the artwork here. A couple more colorful creatures. Right. Brian, say hello.
Hello, how you doing? Good to see you all. We're having fun in Seattle.
Come and visit us, that's for sure. Brian's sharing his new works. They're quite colorful and beautiful.
The hammer is very spiky because he does it with the, you know, with the machine.
Creativity at the fair. Looks like it's mixed media and porcelain or clays. Imagine having these right by your bed. Some people collect teacups. Very fun. Thanks everybody for joining me for a quick tour. People are piling in now for the show, and it is an impressive display. So if you're in the Seattle area, definitely stop by booth A17 to see us here at Habitat. I hope everybody has a great weekend. I hope you're all watching the new season of Blown Away. We have a talk with one of the contestants, John Moran, coming up on the 30th. It is going to be incredible, so make sure you're all caught up on that show on Netflix. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you soon.